What's going on, people, and welcome to Man Knows Football. You are here with Roma, myself, Guni, and the return of a special guest, man like Apple Westcott, the Man United fan. Congratulations, Apple. Obviously, we've got to get that out of the way. Apple just got married, and I believe he's due a daughter as well in a few months. Isn't that right? So it's a double congratulations there. Very good to have you back on the show, Apple. Very good to have you back on the show as well, Romes. You're always here, but it's always good to have you. So, Wolverhampton versus Manchester United. 1-0. United got away with it. Apple, do you want to start with giving me your thoughts?
I'll be honest, there's not really much to say on the game. I think United were both from start to finish. If we're completely honest about performances, you know, no one there really set the place on fire. I think if you, the only things you can say, as a matter of fact, the things that really stood out is how poor some of it. It's the same culprits every week. The ones that are poor. You talk about philosophy. I still think United look a little bit clueless, short on midfielders. I say potentially still short on philosophy. But look, I guess the marks of any team that's going to be successful in any way, shape or form is to play badly and win. It's just unfortunate that United every week seems to just play badly. But that's, I guess, if that's how Solskjaer wants to do things. Look, let's be honest, United, despite having quality in the team now, they're just not a side that's going to cut you open with incisive play or real quality. So, and that's just what it is.
Well, they've got one player in that team that can do that pretty well, but obviously it's not just down to one man in the whole squad. Obviously, Mr. Paul Pogba. Today, what I noticed with him, and I might actually pose this question to Roma, what I saw with Pogba today wasn't necessarily his fault, because people are saying that he was hiding, he weren't turning up. But what I saw was is that Ollie was asking him to play in a bit of a deeper role to support the midfield, which is not what Pogba is actually supposed to do. That's not his job. But Romes,
you give me your defense. He's defending a zero. He shouldn't be nowhere near the back line. That's where things go wrong. Like, that is where things go wrong. When he's on a back line, near the back line, things go left. Things go left. Everyone knows this. Pogba needs to stay away from the defence. Far away from the defence.
No, 100%. Apple, this one's for you. So, obviously, we're going to come on to the positives of United, but just going off the back of what you were saying, you don't really look too happy with the style of play being played. And just looking outside the box here, I noticed that you've got a severe issue in the midfield, because balls are just getting through there way too easily. Fred does not look like the answer. He cannot protect that. He can't shield that back four. And you know, in today's game, a lot of teams play a back five as well, because of just how intense the attacks are in the Premier League. So if you're playing a back four, it's now become essential that you've got a DM that can screen that nicely. Fred is not that guy. Do you feel that Manchester United have to act and get a defensive midfielder to take care of that, who is capable of doing that job before the window closes?
It's interesting that you say that, because I think it's... I know Roma made a few comments about Pogba, him being in and around our own box defensively. I actually disagree. I think Pogba can defend. It's whether he wants to defend, and that's a completely different situation. But at the same time, you're looking at balance, and you know, Pogba, with all of his talent going forwards, and even just being able to play in so many different styles and systems. Look, we're 4 years into Pogba being back at United, and we're still saying the same things with regards to having players that can support him. We've brought in Bruno Fernandes, who's a fantastic attacking option, but I think defensively is a liability. If you've got Pogba and Fernandes in the same midfield, you've got to have two solid defensive midfielders. You must play with a double pivot, but they've not got that. When you talk about style of play, there just isn't a style of play at United. There isn't a way that they play where you can say every week, this is, you know what you're going to look for. You know, they're going to do this, they're going to do that. So there's no clear-cut style of play. There's no clear philosophy. I'll be honest, I think it's poor recruitment again. I think they snatched at the opportunity to sign one or two players, and they've missed out on the opportunity to sign, well, probably the guy that was at fault for the goal that they scored today. And, you know, Ruben Neves, I think, would fit into United perfectly. But, look, it's interesting for me, because, ironically, the person the person who can't pass the ball, like can't screen, his name's Fred and he can't pass the ball. It's insane.
You know, Fred, he can't Fred nothing.
Hey, I like that one.
I've been involved in football 21 years. I've been coaching 21 years. And I've never seen a professional that can't pass the ball. You're guaranteed at least two or three game-changing mistakes from Fred every week. And he done it again today. Scored an own goal last week, as well as giving the ball away. Can't play five-yard passes. Can't play 10-yard passes. Can't shoot. So you say to yourself, what exactly can you do? Oh, you can run, you can cover ground, but you can't catch players on the break. Jimenez looked like he was trying today, got away from him. Embarrassing.
Trincao dropped him in the box as well.
Ooh. Listen, I don't like criticising players because I'm involved in football and I, not just can it come back on me when I see these people, but it's more just professional courtesy. I don't like to insult players.
100%, understand.
But the fact is, he's not good enough. He's not a Manchester United player. We bought him as an attacking midfielder. And he's...
What?
He's a cam. He came from Shakhtar as a cam. Don't you remember?
Shakhtar as an attacking midfielder. And I think Ollie's just had to try to find a position for him.
So wait. So this guy's natural position was attacking midfield and he can't play a pass.
So... You know, it's listen. The Shakhtar chairman bantered us after we bought him. I think he said something. What did he say? He said United will buy anyone. So they slapped a 60 million price tag on him, and we paid it. It was unbelievable. But look, such is life. You know, look, I'd like to say you live and you learn, but we're seeing the same mistakes over and over. So maybe it's just the way that he does things.
Back to back seasons.
Fred's not good enough. McTominay maybe isn't quite creative enough. He's a fantastic athlete. You know what you're going to get from him. He's always going to work hard. He's always going to put in challenges. And when he doesn't play well, he's always going to work hard. And working hard is a talent. And I respect it. I respect it massively. But when you're at Manchester United, you've got to be able to do more than just work hard.
Let me say something quick here. I feel like, see, this transfer window period has been absolutely crazy. But what went wrong was this. Man United and Man City both signed the wrong players. You lot were meant to swap over. That's what was meant to happen. Sancho was meant to be in this Man City team right now because this style of play suits this Man City team. What he's trying to do at United, he gets the ball. Sancho's not the type of player to run in behind. He's not going to run in behind. 100%, you don't do that. 100%. He's the type of man, he wants the ball to feet. He wants to dub the player and get something in. Or he wants to play a 1-2 run into the middle. But it's like no one is on his wavelength. That's why today, he looked like he didn't know what he was doing on the pitch because they're not playing to his strengths.
The thing is, anybody that knows football will know what quality looks like, and you know what players what their mentalities are. You know what their go-to moves are on their own style of play, and how that player's style of play is supposed to fit into your philosophy. Unfortunately for Ollie, I mean, let's be honest. Can anyone here tell me where Sancho was playing today? Can you tell me the position he was actually playing?
Yeah, I don't know if it was playing right, left, attacking mid, cam. I don't know what he was doing. Second striker.
Look, can anyone tell me the system that was being played there? Because it looked to me like as if he'd gone, look, listen, good players go and be good. And that's not good enough.
That's his philosophy. I honestly feel
good
like.
Players go and be good and we'll play on the break. And that's just not good enough. And like you said, it's not Sancho to run in behind teams and try to split people. And look, let's be honest, as a winger, he's not quick. He's not a quick winger. Sancho is what I would call a playmaking wide man. So, or yes. Otherwise known as maybe what we call like a wide 10, so to speak.
Yes.
That's perfect. What I was comparing him to Grealish.
Perfect.
See what I'm saying? Him and Grealish, they should have...
Grealish is a United player. Sancho is well, look, I say he's more of a City player. He's more of a Pep player because I mean, it's not about clubs. It's about style of play. And I think that Sancho makes Pep a little more because he's more incisive. He's a bit more pinpoint with the things that he wants to do. He wants to give and go. He wants to do short bursts and sharp movements. Give, triangles, in behind, diamonds. He wants to play up and back. He wants to switch play. United just aren't dynamic like that. We're very one-dimensional at the minute. We want to play forwards. We want to be direct. We want to play balls in behind. You want to try to catch teams on the break. You want to play for Pogba to be powerful and slip the ball at the last second. Look, you've got Bruno Fernandes running off the shoulder of the last man, and you say to yourself, when you're 10, he's running off the shoulder of the last man, Well, he's a striker. What's he doing? Well, then who's covering the position of the 10? Now he's pressing the ball. When the ball transfers over, you know, when possession turns over, who's in that space now to go with the ball back? Now you talk about, you've got Mason Greenwood, who's a striker, chasing the ball. Bruno Fernandes, for me, he's a blessing and a curse, because for all of the things that he does well, and for me, the only thing he does well is put the ball in the back of the net, but he's a midfielder. He's got to be able to defend. He's got to be able to chase players. And the thing is, he reads the game, he's just really lazy with what he does, but everyone screams at Pogba for being lazy defensively. And he's by far worse than Paul Pogba. He gives the ball away 10 times more. He gives away more fouls. He certainly... Look, you can say he tries more passes, but the only passes I remember in games are the fantastic ones that Pogba makes. It's Pogba that makes breathtaking passes off his left and right foot. Half volley, backspin, no backspin, curl. Doesn't matter how the ball comes, you do it on one touch, you do it on two touch. Fernandes, he attempts a lot, kind of like Sanchez. But how many of the things that he does actually comes off? And I've got to be honest with you, hardly any at all.
Mm-hmm.
So, but again, look, the thing with Fernandes, and I think perhaps maybe not a lot of people know this, is that he's a failed striker. His academy career, he was a striker. He wasn't fast enough. And he wasn't strong enough. Big enough or strong enough to be a striker, so he played as a carefree 10. Now, he was decent on the ball because he wasn't a speed demon, so he learned how to control the ball, so they dropped him in the hole behind, sort of in a bit of an older system. And that's kind of how he played. He played without any defensive duties. You come to United, again, this is Manchester United we're talking about. You've got to be able to defend, you've got to be able to pass, you've got to be able to run, you've got to be able to do absolutely everything. Now, if you're going to be a master in one element of the game, you have to recruit players that are going to be masters in the other elements that he's lacking.
Yeah.
But they've not done that. And that's a big surprise, because the start of the window, you go and buy Varane, who I think is going to come good. I think he didn't have a bad game today.
No, he didn't at all.
I saw a few ropey bits, but it's his first game in the United shirt. It's a big ask to come from Spain and play in the Premier League. I think he got a big wake-up call in the corner where De Gea pulled off a double save. I think he got a big wake-up call. Even the small teams have got big, physical, strong strikers and big, physical, strong players. They're going to put their hands on you. They're not going to give you any respect. They're not going to stand off and be in awe of the badge on your shirt. They're going to go and get stuck in. They're going to ruffle your feathers. They're going to try and have a goal.
Before you continue, because you was going to come on to something I was going to mention. Speaking of power and strength, there's a certain player there at flipping Wolverhampton that cannot be stopped. Absolutely cannot be stopped. But once it gets into the box, forget about it. All bets are off. You're guaranteed he's not putting it in the back of the net. Adama Traore. Go on, Rome's.
Now I was going to say, that boy there has end product. He wins Ballon d'Or, bruv.
Yeah, listen, big man ting, he's in the wrong sport. That man is a wide receiver. That's what he
running
is.
Back. He's a running
he's
back.
He's a running back or wide receiver back, or something. Because this guy, you see, when he goes on charge, I saw Fred and somebody else trying to, I think it was Luke Shaw trying to stop him. And
Luke Shaw had a mare today, bro. Fred had a mare today. You know, one in that team can stop him, bro.
You know, Luke Shaw. Luke Shaw, very slyly, not only is he very quick, but Luke Shaw slyly is 6'1", 6'2". He's not small. Lukey's not small. And obviously you can see he's a bit robust. But Luke's not small, he's not slow, and he struggled so badly. And again, I'm talking about your defensive midfielder. So it's coming covering these wide areas and help you fall back out. Good God. He was chasing shadows. And it weren't even Adama's shadow. He was chasing his own shadow. Because the positioning that he picks up, he says to himself, are you really a professional footballer? And you don't understand how to track runners and how to make covering runs. And again, you say, look, Luke Shaw's trying to delay Adama as much as he can. He's getting involved in a physical battle, shoulder to shoulder. We know Adama's 4 or 5 yards quicker than anybody on the pitch. Now, Varane's lightning, but Adama's quicker. And again, you say, look, he's 3-4 yards quicker than anybody else on the pitch. So Luke Shaw's doing what's supposed to be by delaying him as much as you can. And Adama's smart because he puts Vaseline all over his arm so you can't hold him up for too long. And you're saying, right, where's my DM? He's got to get in between, and that space behind me, he's got to go and fucking cover me. And he's not covering him.
He's
tripping over his feet. He's too slow. He doesn't read it. He doesn't get into the space. He goes, Jesus Christ. Now Maguire's got to come out. And that, there was that one chance where I think it's Trankau got the run. I got the run on Fred, and you say, right now Maguire's got to come out, and you think, Jesus, Maguire had to come out, commit himself, went through Maguire's legs. He gets into the box, and you think, Jesus, this should be a goal, and you get away with one.
Yep.
And it's just, you know, and it's like, Jesus Christ, at what point do you realise that, you know, there's a, it's not even alarm bells, it's like, Jesus, this is fucking serious. But you invest big money in the squad again this year, big money they've invested. But I just think you've got to prioritise the defensive midfielder and something that actually allows Pogba and Fernandes to go and make these mistakes a little more, I'm going to say freely, because it's not going to cost them quite as much if they've got someone behind them that can actually cover the spaces properly and distribute the ball and pass the ball, maybe be a bit more of an orchestrator from behind them. Because I think right now you've got the patience running the asylum, and it's insane.
This is what I'm saying. You see what you're talking about, what you want Fred to do. You know who's actually great at doing that, yeah? That you don't get the credit for. Jorginho. What he does for Alonso,
It's not your day. It's not your day. Yeah, we don't care.
It's not my day. Fair enough. True. Fair enough. It's not my day. We go. United's day.
So... So Apple, so far, obviously, it's like you said, but the bottom line is this, is that it doesn't matter how the win comes, and sometimes, no matter how good you are, you do have to win ugly.
You still have to grind results, and we know that, and I think they managed to do that today by the skin of their teeth. Poor goalkeeper for Wolves. Well, he's unlucky goalkeeper. I don't think he's actually poor, but I think he's had a bit of a clanger there, but I have to give credit to Greenwood because it's his favourite move. He wants to do a step over and shift. The problem with Greenwood is that you can't read him because he can go on his right foot.
Right or left.
Uh-huh.
And he can hit with the exact same pinpoint accuracy. Now, what I will say is, in Greenwood's favour, whether the keeper touches it or not, it's going in. But if you watch it's going into the far corner. He's got it down to a fine art. Step, shift, bang. And he does it all in half a yard.
He's the best at it.
Defender will tell you the worst. You know, the worst thing a striker can do for a defender is shift it and hit it quickly and early. You can't even get a blocker, you can't even dangle a leg in front of the ball because he steps and shifts it so quickly. The problem is, defensively, when he does a step and shift, if he doesn't shoot and he pushes it past you and you've stuck your leg out, you've given away a penalty. It's a guaranteed penalty. So in any case, all you can do is kind of let him go and get his shot off. I hope that the goalkeeper's going to do his job, and unfortunately, keeper had a bit of a clanger there, I think one of those ones. It can end up anywhere. He just fluffed his lines a little bit. He didn't want to give one away at his near post, and in the end, they've given away one in the back of their own net. But such is life.
Well, the pressure. Well, to be honest with you, you had to make the opportunity anyway. It was positive pressure from United at that point. One-way traffic almost, although you were getting hit a few times on the counter, but you leave yourself exposed when you're trying to attack and get a goal anyway, so you can't have it all, can you? But it's...
why can't you have it all? You're Manchester United, you're not fucking Newcastle. So you shouldn't...
I'm more speaking in the terms of, like, in terms of tactics. Because, listen, no matter how good you are, right?
I completely disagree.
There has to be a weakness in every tactic, though, Apple. And when you do counter and you do go forward, you leave yourself exposed.
You leave yourself exposed to some elements of the game, and you know there's going to be elements of calculated risk, but I completely disagree because it's the players within the system that make the vulnerabilities. And it's Fred. It's Fred. Fred's the vulnerability there because when Pogba, Fernandes, Sancho, I hate to say it, Daniel James, Greenwood, all those guys, they're pushed forwards and they're trying to pop up in good spaces and they're trying to do good things. They're still playing with a bit of fear because they know if they give the ball away, the man behind them's not there to cover him. They know that. They know. The second the ball breaks in behind them, Pogba knows, fuck, I don't want to play that pass because if it don't come off, they're in.
So basically what you're saying is that if United had recruited properly in that position, then these things shouldn't be happening or that wouldn't be a weakness at all.
Look, we never replaced Michael Carrick when he retired. That's the only position we didn't replace.
Mm.
And it's the one position that continues to bite us in the ass. The thing is, when you want to play out from the back and you want to be a possession team, you need to have a holding midfielder that can both create from deep, and can defend. Fred can do neither. So why is he there?
Who is your man of the match for today, Apple?
I think Trankau or Adama Traore. I thought they were brilliant today for Wolves. I thought Neves was good as well. I thought Messina was good. I'll be honest, it's really tough for me to... I think the top five players on that pitch are all in an orange shirt. It's a hard one for Wolves. They've played well again. They've not got the result that I feel like maybe they deserved, even if it was a draw. But I don't give a fuck about Wolves. I'm not a Wolves fan, so it is what it is. That's their problem. Man of the match for me, I'll probably give it to Trankau. I thought it was a constant problem the whole game. He was picking up the ball in really dangerous areas. He was direct at times. He was really quick to release the ball out into Adama. I think he'd done that exceptionally well, supported the attack really well. I would have personally given it to Trankau.
Fair play. Roams, for you, who was your man of the match that game?
Yeah, it would either be Trankau or Adama, but I'll give it to... I'll just slightly edge it to Adama.
I have to agree with that. He caused the most problems today. And I hate using this term, but it's really true. They didn't know what to do with him. Literally. They did not know what to do with him.
It's embarrassing. But at the same time, when you've got a player that's got that kind of quality, that kind of athleticism, I mean, he's got those talents. Because look, it's one thing to have that pace and power, and I hate the
PNP
term. you got the PNP, but do you know how to use it? And let's be honest, he knows how to use it. The problem is when he gets himself into spaces that he's created for himself, you expect him to show just a little bit more quality. And I don't think he's got the quality to do that, which is why he doesn't play for Spain. Although he's beginning to play, it's why he's not a regular for Spain, because technically he's off the pace. These are things that you got to learn as a 12-year-old, not when you're 25. So,
facts.
But the thing is, if Adama goes to Tottenham as expected, I think he continues his growth, and I think he becomes even more of a problem. I think if you see Adama Traore in the Champions League, not that Tottenham will touch the Champions League at all, but if he ever touches the Champions League, he'll end up at a big club.
Yeah, facts.
Okay, so you heard it here from Apple. Actually, well said, because to be honest with you, he dropped a lot of gems there. So if you're listening, there's a lot for you to learn there, especially about just down to tactics about football and some of the things that Apple said. So really peep what he said. We are going to actually do another video. So this is going to be one of two videos. Stay tuned in for the second one. We will be talking about the Cristiano Ronaldo move to Manchester United. Obviously, we've got a Manchester United fan here, so we thought now is the right time to do so. But yeah, thank you everyone for tuning in, and thank you for the support so far, man. Listen, like last week, we was on like 500 subscribers, and we was just like, listen, if we get to 650, we'll be happy. We're now on 705. So to the support that everybody's been giving, thank you very much. And please continue to do so. Innit? We're still young. We're still small. So just keep pushing. Keep pushing. But from now, Roams, Apple, thank you very much for joining me on this one. And obviously, we're going to do the next. But to everyone that's tuned in, make sure you like, share, subscribe, all of that good stuff. You'll find Roma and Apple's details down there in the description. Make sure you click those links. Make sure you follow.
Link me.